Rich Nipolito, if you don't mind standing. Richard and his wife of 14 years are residents of Roswell, 14-year residents of Roswell. He has served as the Post One Councilman since 2008, and for 2 years prior, he served on the Roswell Planning Commission. He's also served on the Roswell Redevelopment Task Force and the Holton Ridge Beach Revitalization Task Force. He has spent 25 years working in architectural design and real estate, and he is a partner with the Concordia Property. His public service includes serving as a trustee for the Roswell North Education Foundation, chairman of the Blue Ribbon Committee, and he has served on the North Fulton Comprehensive Transportation Plan Stakeholders Committee. Thank you. Mr. Nipolito.
Thank you. I'd like to thank the Roswell Women's Club for organizing this forum. It takes a lot of work to put something like this on, and I really appreciate all the effort. And I appreciate each and every one of you for being here tonight. I'd also like to thank my lovely wife, Kelly, and my daughters, Caitlin and Kristen, whose love and support really make it possible for me to serve each and every one of you. I have a lot of conversations with Roswell residents. The one thing I consistently hear is that they love Roswell because it's such a great place to live. That's why my first priority is protecting and enhancing our quality of life. Through attractive neighborhoods, quality recreation, beautiful parks, creative arts and culture, and excellent schools. We also have a scenic river setting, historic charm, quality restaurants, and abundant festivals and events. All these go into making Roswell a unique, thriving community. We have a quality of life here in Roswell that is second to none. I'd put our quality of life up against any other city in this entire nation. That's why my family and I are glad to call Roswell home. That's why each of you are as well, I'm sure. It's also why I consider it a pleasure to serve our community. And while I will fight to protect our neighborhoods and enhance our quality of life, with a rebounding real estate market, we need to be especially vigilant in reviewing development proposals to protect against negative impacts to our existing neighborhoods, city services, and city infrastructure. Quality growth is essential. Roswell's fortunate to have over 900 acres of parkland and a number of streams and creeks all within its borders. These natural resources provide recreation and education opportunities, as well as hundreds of acres of undisturbed natural area for our city. Continued protection, maintenance, and investment in these natural assets contributes to our great quality of life. Just as integral to our Roswell community are schools, the arts, and an abundance of nonprofit organizations, all of which enrich our lives in very meaningful ways. Partnerships with these organizations enable each organization to expand its ability to serve Roswell and enhance our quality of life. Thank you so much for being here this evening. Your involvement in our community makes Roswell a better place.
Thank you. Mr. DeBlito.
Thank you. Mr. Gray, I certainly hope that when you have a child with the birth announcements in the newspaper.
No charge.
Thank you. I'm going to hold you to that.
Once again, I'd like to thank the Roswell Women's Club for hosting this event, and I'd like to thank Mr. Hurd for being a wonderful moderator tonight. Thank you so much. I started off tonight talking about quality of life, and quality of life doesn't just happen. It's something that you have to plan for, and we need to plan for a good foundation. And part of that is that we need to strengthen our local economy, we need to promote redevelopment, we need to improve transportation. Those are things we talked a little bit about here tonight, and they're all way too big topics to try to cover in such a short period of time. But I talk a lot about it on my website, so if you go to richforroswell.com, there's plenty of information in there that tells you about my perspective on all that, and I'd love for you to take a look at it. It's been an honor and a pleasure serving each and every one of you. I hope I have the opportunity to continue that. I look forward to serving you and also protecting and enhancing our quality of life. I appreciate your vote on November 3rd. Thank you very much.
Thank you.